All right, so the next thing is, now that we have written the equations that we want, okay, so we've written three basic or four basic equations. You can see them very powerfully written. The next thing that I want to show you is how to write equation numbers, okay, and automate them. So as you write the equation numbers become glaringly, increasingly available for you. So to start with, all you need to do is to find any specific place to design the equation number stuff. So I usually design it in the form of a table, so then I can always refer to it, and I used to save it as a template, so at any given point I can refer to it and just insert it into the document. To insert the equation, the first thing I used to do is to insert the table. There's a table that I used to design and make it sequential and in such a way that it keeps increasing as I insert the equation. So to insert the table, I can just come all the way to insert here and come to table. I usually have it in three cells. I just select the three cells and I can move the cells to the extreme edge, the borders. I can move them to the edges. Okay, I can move them to edges just like so. And I usually want my equations to have these three dots before the parentheses. Okay, so three dots, then my parentheses, number one, number two, number three, just like so. All right, so I come back to inside the parentheses and I define the sequential control. So I just make sure that my cursor is inside the parentheses, and then I can come back to insert. I can go to field over here and make sure the category selected all, and then you can come all the way to sequence, right, letter S, so you can see sequence, you can see sequence over here, and then I can make it sequential equation, okay, equation like this, leave everything as it is and click on OK, and you can see it has given us numbering 1. Okay, so we can come back inside this center cell and go to equation, come to insert, and then you can go all the way to equation, and you can see the equation editor has been inserted. Now with the equation editor inserted, we can select this and save it as a preset. So anytime I can always refer to it, I can select it, come to insert again, come all the way to equation, click on this small drop down and save equation to gallery. I can select to save this equation. I can make it equation table, something like that, and can just say okay. At any given point, I can easily insert the equation from here. So let's say I want to insert my equations here. I can just select this, copy, and then come inside this equation editor and just paste it. Okay, so you can see it. And what I usually do, I usually remove the borders. I select this and then I can come all the way here, come all the way to the home tab, okay, and then come to this border effect and then say no border, and everything goes back out without border, and it appears more professional without the border. Okay, so if I want to insert another equation here, I can just go ahead and come to insert and come to equation over here and just go all the way down, and you can see equation table over here, and you can see it over here. So very easily you can just start writing your equation. I can select here and I can come back here and insert any equation of my choice. For example, I want to insert this equation. You can see I have inserted it, but then I have the option to manually be removing the borders. Okay, you can remove it manually and say no border, or you can do it at the same time, okay, at the point of creation of this table. Okay, you can remove the borders at that point. But one thing you should pay attention to is the sequential increase. You see, it keeps on increasing. If I want to add another equation, it's going to increase the same way. Okay, so you can see insert equation, then I can go to equation table, and you can see I can just select it and come to equation. I want to put in any equation, and you can see it has inserted it and it has given me the equation number 3. Can select, come to no borders and select no borders, and you can see you are done. But then what happens when consistently you can add and it remains updated? If you have to have another equation at the top or in between your equation 1 and 2, what happens after that? Well, let's say at the top here, we insert another equation, come here, and then you go to over here and then insert another equation. But unfortunately, you can see it is giving us equation 1. Okay, so let's say we insert this equation, we can come over here, insert this long equation, and then you can see it's still making equation 1. So what I used to do is I select the entire equation in that document. I used to select the entire equation, then I can right click anywhere and say update field. Once you say update field, it's going to update it to 1, 2, 3, 4, just like so. So it's going to give all your equation numberings professionally. So let's select this and say no border. And you can see it is now perfectly done. So you see how easily you can add equation numbers to your equations. I hope you enjoyed this video. That does it for this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.
Thank you.